I've always thought that to really paint something, you have to live and breathe it. I've been coming to Italy in search of subject matter for most of my life, and in recent years have made my base here in Venice. I'm interested in the way Venice has occupied such a significant place in our collective imagination, and how multifaceted that image has been. Over the centuries, Venice has presented herself in a series of memorable guises, whether of civic harmony, romantic decay, or more recently as host to the glittering world of contemporary art and film. One of the reasons why I chose Venice was that I thought it would be a good place to develop that part of my painting which has to do with colour, tonality, and above all, light. Light is to me the very life, the very soul of painting. It's no accident that the painters who brought a radically new understanding of luminosity to European art were Venetian. Venice is, in essence, a supremely visual place. Weathered surfaces and reflections, seen under an ever-changing light which is filtered through the atmosphere of the lagoon. The traditions of Venetian art must have been deeply informed by the kinds of daily visual experiences common to the inhabitants of the city. There are obvious parallels between objects represented by a reflection in a canal made of 1,000 shimmering fragments and a pattern of a Byzantine mosaic, or indeed of a certain kind of painting built up of a myriad of brushstrokes of carefully measured tone. I often describe my subject matter as people and the spaces they inhabit. My early studies were in architecture, and I've always maintained a great interest in buildings and public spaces. The historic centres of Italian towns are characterised by a harmonious, measured, yet immensely vital architecture in the humanistic tradition. For me, this is a source of subjects for painting like no other. For much of its existence, Venice has been a preferred destination for artists, from the dreadful to the sublime. And I suppose a large part of this city's fascination lies in its ever-changing moods. As Henry James said, it is also quiet and sad and faded, and yet so brilliant and so living.